Welcome back to Living 808. Now, we are just 3 days away from our first casting call for Hawaii's first CW star. The event is this Saturday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. at Pearl Ridge Center. Today, though, we're getting to know one of our judges a little bit better. Say hello to editor-in-chief of Dysfunction Magazine, Hugette Montesinos. Hello. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you guys for having me.
Before we talk about the event, thank you, by the way, for being one of our judges. I know it's going to be a tough job. Tell us about this magazine, Dysfunction Magazine.
Sure. So we are a fashion, art, and culture publication. We target the 17 to 35 female. And really, our general concept is to exhort women towards a higher standard of living. So the magazine started as a counterculture publication where we would sort of redefine standards of beauty and what women should really strive for. So while many magazines really talk about losing weight and how to attain certain things or how to look like someone else, we really try to re-identify what that is for each woman and to have them find themselves and to really search for who they were called to be and what their purpose is.
I love that. As a parent of a young girl, too, I think this is the kind of magazine that you want them reading.
Sure.
What kind of articles? Can you give us an example of what readers might be able to expect?
Absolutely. So, well, I like to say that a certain element of it is the fluff type of article, which is really more the culture, the art, the fashion, which is really ingrained in us anyway, and they're things that we love and we enjoy as part of entertainment. We really touch deep on some meaty articles about issues that women face, identity, body issues, things such as abuse, drugs. So we really talk about everything from a very scientific perspective, and we talk to a lot of experts. We ask them questions about how these things affect their lives. So we really want to make sure that we're matching up these things and these ideals that we have with science and what's been proven through sociology.
Okay, now this is a national magazine, so our viewers, if you're not familiar with it, they can go in and get this magazine. You also have a really great website.
Thank you. Yes, yeah. We started off as a local Hawaii publication. Very quickly, a year later, we became national, and so now we're actually distributing all over the United States at all Barnes & Noble and national bookstores, as well as chains in Canada and Australia.
Wow, congratulations. Yeah. Now, you lived in Hawaii, then you moved away for a little bit and came back. Tell us about that.
Yes, so I actually moved here about 10 years ago, and I was living here for 8 years and then moved back to Miami for a couple of years, and I've just reinstated myself back here. Been back for about 3.5 months now.
Okay, but it's great because I think what you do, you can probably do from anywhere.
Yeah, pretty much. I like to say that we're sort of nomadic in nature because pretty much anywhere I have my computer, I can work out of. And the really beautiful thing about you know, working these days is just dealing with people through the cyber world. We have contributors all over the country and actually outside the country, so it's very easy. And I love to travel, and it's one of the large elements of the magazine as well. So it just really fits hand in hand with, you know, we practice what we preach.
That's wonderful. That sounds like a dream job.
It is.
But this Saturday, you're going to be helping us out, right? We've got our first CW search. Again, the event is from 11 to 2. As a judge, what do you think you're going to be looking for?
Ooh, well, you know, I know this word gets thrown a lot, out a lot, and the element of authenticity is something that I can almost like breathe. I can very easily sense when someone's being authentic, and honestly, I'm refreshed when I watch TV and I see people that their soul sort of shines, you know? So I'm looking for someone that has a very authentic personality, somebody that just attracts me magnetically, and I think a lot of that is having pizzazz, having very clear voice. Obviously, when you watch TV, you want to make sure you understand what people are saying. I'm looking for someone who's exciting and who just, I mean, outside of the looks element, obviously, you know, a lot of people are going to focus on fashion, or they would assume that I'm just going to think about the fashion elements. But I really am looking for someone whose personality will shine, not through just what they're wearing, but also what they say and how their message comes across.
Okay, that's good. That's a lot.
It is.
But that's, you know, they've got a big job for a year. They're going to be here with us on Living 808 and then also the spokesperson for CW.
So right, that's a big deal.
It is a big deal. It's a paid position. We're so happy that we're doing this for the first time, and we appreciate that you taking time out of your schedule and being there with us on Saturday.
Oh, I'm honored. I think it's great. You know, I'm not really huge on judging people because it's kind of something I'm not naturally always wanting to do, but I think this is a great opportunity because it's not necessarily judging and saying this person makes it and this person doesn't, but I think it's a really great opportunity for everyone to learn. And I think even those who might not be the person who ends up getting the position, I think for all of us, it's really kind of an exciting season and an exciting experience to see what a qualification would look like or what people are looking for. And if anything, you know, maybe next year and the couple other years that they might do it again.
Yeah, no, I agree. Absolutely. Thank you so much for joining us.